So this is a flight into Tanzanat Airport and the approach wasn't managed correctly, so let's have a look. So at the moment we're descending, passing flight level 160, we're doing 300 knots, and let me just skip back a bit. The distance, it says here it's 94 miles, but you can see it goes all the way around the arrival, and there doesn't seem to be much traffic here, so we could expect a shortcut. So if you expect a shortcut, you can use another way of finding the distance, either via the range arcs here or the VOR distance or perhaps the ILS DME. Let's use the VOR. This will be a line straight from the current position to the VOR, which is usually not what you do either. So it's a little bit more than that, but let's say 50 miles to have some idea about the profile. So 50 miles times 3 is flight level 150. We are doing 300 knots, so we should fly 3,000 feet lower, so that's flight level 120. Okay, so you can already see that we're way high on profile. So we're going to continue the flight, and there's our shortcut. So now we can use the FMS distance to see exactly what the exact distance is. And anytime after you get a shortcut, you should immediately do a profile calculation to figure out if you're on profile or not. So we just calculated already, and we are definitely above profile. And if you're above profile, what you should do is increase your drag. Now, if you're far away from the airfield, 80 miles or more, you could increase the speed and open descent, but this will not really do much if you're closer, because this method, it just takes time, and we don't have that time, because at some point we need to slow down to flight level to 250 knots at flight level 100. And so this method of generating drag of open descent speed up, it doesn't work well after about 80 miles. So here we should just apply the speed brake, but no speed brake is applied. Okay, so that's the first mistake. So let's do our next profile calculation. Okay, so here you can see the speed is increased in open descent, and you will see later that yeah, this helps a little bit, but really not that much. You do have to watch your descent rate though if you do that. Okay, let's skip ahead. And so there's approaching 40 miles. So at 40 miles, we times 3, we should be at flight level 120 minus 3,000 feet to slow down. Actually, we're a bit more than 300 knots, but so that makes 9,000 feet. So at 40 miles, we should be at 9,000 feet with this speed. Now you can see already that still we are high on profile. Okay, so there's 40 miles, yeah. So we're 2,000 feet too high, and probably a bit more because we're faster than 300 knots. So we should apply the speed brake. Okay, we're clear to our next altitude. I'm not sure if we had a high speed descent in this case or not. I can't remember. But if you don't have a high speed descent, you should do VS0. Yeah, I guess there was no high speed descent here because the vertical speed was reduced to. But of course, that won't work if you don't select your speed lower, and either way it will take some time, so then you're gonna bust your speed constraint here. So again, I'm not sure if that was the case, but I assume so because vertical speed is selected here, vertical speed 0. Okay, so that's the other mistake. Now we're passing transition at the same time, so the workload is high, so it's easy to forget that for both crew. So it's something to watch out for. Okay, next speed is set at 230, I guess because we are still flying level at VS0, and it's easy to forget because that's what we did before, and we're doing the approach checklist now, and again, easy to forget. But at least the speed is selected lower now. And also, I guess the other reason is to reduce the speed to 250 knots below 10,000 feet. And once the speed is 250, you can increase again to 250 knots. So let's see if that happens. Let me skip ahead a bit. So they're approaching 250 knots. So there's 250 knots. Now we can descend further. And yeah, there you go. Descent mode, thrust idle. The aircraft has more drag. So you see now that the speed brake's selected. And to me, this is an indication that the first officer is not quite aware of the profile. Because if you rely only on these messages, more drag, then that's just, you should not do that. You should calculate yourself if you're above profile or not. Because sometimes this message is correct, sometimes it's not. Like before, it should have told you already that you were high on profile, and it didn't do that. And sometimes you will find that it says more drag, but in fact, you're not high on profile at all. Okay, so anyway, we have the speed brake selected now. And we can do our next profile calculation. Let me skip ahead a bit until I have a distance in view. And by the way, if you don't have the distance on the FMS, you can always use it from the ILS DME, provided you are on final or on final track anyway. Okay, so let me go back a bit, 30 miles. So yeah, okay, so let's use the distance from the ILS here. So there's 30 miles. So 30 times 3 is 9,000 feet. We're doing 250 knots, so we should fly 2,000 feet lower. So we should be at 7,000 feet. So we are definitely above profile. So we need a speed break. Okay, so let's move. Let's continue the video. And the next altitude calculation we can do at 20 miles. So 20 times 3 is 6,000 feet minus, okay, we are a bit in between green dot and 250, but we're closer to 250, so we use 2,000 feet. So we should be at 4,000 feet here. And we can still see that we are above profile. Okay, so the speed brake is still selected, so that's good. We also have a bit of a tailwind. That doesn't help. The weight is quite light. It's 52.5 tons, so that's very light. So that will help. Regardless, you still need the speed brake. However, the speed brake was still stowed. This is not correct. Anytime you are above profile, you need drag, and then you need the speed brake in this case. So do not stow the speed brake when you are above profile. That does not help. Okay, so perhaps the first officer thought, oh, I'm below the glide slope here. Well, yes, but you're also very fast, so you need to take that into account. Okay, now about 5,000 feet, you want to slow down to green knot speed. It doesn't have to be as exact. Maybe there was a speed constraint by ATC, or maybe they said the remain high speed. I'm not sure what the case was. It's been a while ago since I recorded this video. So let's skip ahead a little bit more. Again, the aircraft has more drag, which is true in this case. You need more drag because you're above profile. So now we're approaching 15 miles. So at 15 miles, we just remember that this is 4,500 feet, but that's without the speed modification. So we should be, well, it's not quite green dot. If it would be green dot, we should fly 3,500 feet, but it's closer to 250 knots. So actually we should be at 2,000 feet, which of course you can't, of 2,500 feet, which you can't do because of the altitude constraint. No, in this case you can actually do that. But regardless, we will want to intercept the glide slope at 3,000 feet. So, but the point is that you are high on energy. So you want to do something about that with the speed brake. Okay, so next what we want to do is to intercept the glide slope at 3,000 feet. Two ways to do that. You either fly level at 3,000 feet and then when the speed passes, when the glide slope diamond is at one dot below the glide slope, then you apply flap 2, or you are, like in this case, a bit higher on profile, then you maintain one dot below the glide slope, make sure your speed is below VVNX, and then when you pass 3,000 feet, then you select flap 2. Okay, so flap 1 is now selected. Normally you want to select flap 1 at about 15 miles, but anyway, we are too fast for that here. So we slow down a bit more, and then now flap 1 is selected, that's fine. However, you want to slow down in this case. You don't want to select flap and do nothing with that. You select flap only to get rid of VLS if you want to use a speed brake, or to slow down the aircraft. So flap 1 is selected here, and regardless, you have to slow down the aircraft anyway. Okay, so now the speed is managed, so that's good. Excellent. So now the other thing is you don't really want to fly the approach or the intercept the approach in descent mode because you have no control over the vertical speed. You might end up high, you might end up low. You want to control the aircraft exactly. You want to put the aircraft on the approach where you want it to and not at some random point what the descent mode does. Like in this case, the VDEV says that you are high on profile. Okay, debatable. On profile, yes, because you're fast, but the FMS has pre-calculated speeds everywhere, so you're not really high in that sense. But you are. What will happen is because the speed is managed and it's in descent mode, it will just raise the nose and reduce the vertical speed to reduce the speed here, and then you'll end up above the glide slope, and that's not what you want. This is one of the reasons why you do not want to use descent mode when intercepting the glide slope. Okay, so so now you can definitely see that you're high on energy. This is without calculating it, just looking at the PFD, You are one knot below the glide slope, almost at 3,000 feet. That's normally a good point to select flap 2. However, you are way too fast. You can't select flap 2. And one thing to watch out for, if you are on the glide slope or above the glide slope passing 3,000 feet and you cannot select flap 2, you should put the gear down to create extra drag. Otherwise, you might not fly a stable approach. Now, at this point, and yes, you're above VFE next, so you can't select flap 2, but we're also below the glide slope. So this may or may not be a problem. We just have to wait a little bit. Okay, so let's see what happens. So the speed is reducing, we're almost on the glide slope, the GS is armed, and now flap 2 is selected here. I would say that's too early, you can see me pointing at it. Yes, you are below VFE next, so technically you can select the flaps. However, in reality, you have to be careful with the if there's a bit of turbulence and also the weight. Now, we are very light, yes, there's a bit of a tailwind, maybe not that much turbulence, although there's some weather on the radar here. But it's a bit too close for comfort to select flap 2. So you can see that, okay, flap 2, and then suddenly you're very close to VFE next, so you want to wait a little bit more. And the other reason why not select flap 2 here is, like, normally you can there's plenty of room to slow down further because we're very light. Sometimes you are heavier and then you want to you cannot do that. You have to select flap as soon as you are a little bit below VFE next. In which case you have to fly a bit of a level segment. I have another video of explaining exactly that, but for now there's no need to select flap 2 so early. If you need to drag, then you just get lower the gear instead. Okay, so there's glide slope start speed. This is also a risk where it goes into glide slope start, will lower the nose, and especially with a bit of tailwind. If you're close to Vmax, then it could happen that the aircraft starts to accelerate again and you're getting very close to Vmax. So another reason to lower the gear here. Okay, so in glide slope start, now the gear down, so that's good, excellent. That will create some additional drag. And we start descending on the glide slope. Now you can see now the autopilot is disconnected. I'm not sure why the first officer did this. There's absolutely no reason to do that. We're fully configured. We're fully stable on the not fully stable either. we are on the glide slope. We're on the localizer. Autopilot was in, and everything is fine. The gear is down, and you just have to wait until the speed reduces. You can add some flaps and happy days. But instead, he elected to disconnect the autopilot. I can't remember what the reason was. Maybe he wanted to practice a bit on manual flying. Regardless, this is not a good time to do that because you're kind of fast, and now you increase your workload and also the workload from the pilot monitoring to make sure that, okay, we need to select some more flaps quickly, and then also do the landing checklist, etc., etc. Meanwhile, monitor the path because you're flying manually. So yeah, so that's better not to do that. Anyway, so now flap 3 selected and flap full. And let me skip ahead a bit. We should be stable by the time we are at, I see. So gear down, flap full, already almost stable on speed here. And we'll definitely fly a stable approach here. So yes, there was a few things to learn from this. I hope you enjoyed and see you next time. If you like this video, please consider buying my book, Practical Descent Energy Management. It contains loads of examples of how to manage a descent and approach, and it is the only book available on this subject. There is a paperback and an ebook version available. You can find a link in the description below.